In perhaps the biggest move in recent tech history, Microsoft has now successfully integrated OpenAI's new model Prometheus into their search engine Bing. But will it give Bing the edge it always needed to get ahead of Google? Well, stick with me for a few minutes. I'm going to walk you through some features and demos, and you can see for yourself firsthand whether Bing is now better than Google. Microsoft starts out by calling this your AI-powered copilot for the web. And they start off by showing Bing and Edge with these four options that they can now perform: search, answer, chat, and create. They place search on the X-axis with things like Reddit, Amazon, YouTube, and of course, Google. And then they place on the Y-axis generative AI, such as ChatGPT, Anthropic, Jasper, and so on. And they go on to show that what they're essentially doing is taking Bing from its category here and moving it up to the intersection of search and generative AI. Now, this is only possible due to their great investment in OpenAI, which, among other things, made this next generation large language model. What is really cool is that the new project that OpenAI was working on is actually customized for search, and it's said to be more powerful than ChatGPT. They call this model the Prometheus model, and it's said to do several things. So improve relevancy of your searches, annotate answers, have up-to-date results, which we know is one of the shortcomings of ChatGPT, understand geolocation, as well as increase safety. And actually, for a short period of time, they included Prometheus in their core search index, and they saw the largest boost in search relevancy in over 20 years. And what does this mean for us, the users? Well, this is when we dive into the user experience. The new Bing landing page looks something like this. Now, when we search for something, such as compare the most influential Mexican artists and their top paintings, we come to something which is kind of like a mixture between search and ChatGPT. So on the left side, you can see your kind of normal web results, but on the right side, you see a nice breakdown kind of summarized there for you. And what's really cool about this model is that it shows you references with links to the original websites. Now, this is a huge deal because with sources, we can verify that this information is correct. And there's actually this thumbs up and thumbs down where you can kind of also give some information like, hey, I checked this source and it actually doesn't say that. Or, hey, this was all perfect. And this will continually improve this model and ensure that our information is accurate. And that is immensely important when you're dealing with such a powerful AI like this one. Another search we could do is kind of time relevancy. For example, events in Scottsdale during the Super Bowl. And you can see here that it says, hey, the Super Bowl's on February 12th. And it then lists some events that are happening around Scottsdale at this time. So here you can really see the combination of geolocation and time-based results. Now, touching on the more informational answers, you can see here this very funny question of, will this IKEA love seat fit into my car? So what Bing returns here are the dimensions of the IKEA love seat, which is already helpful, but then also the cargo space of your car. And it says, you know what, with the seats up, there's no chance, which is already very helpful information. But it says with the seats down, you know, it might depend on how you're orienting this love seat. And that might be true. So some things Bing is not going to be able to answer for you, but at least it's giving you some relevant information, even in this very complex question. Okay, let's go with a more classic kind of example where you want to buy something. Let's say a pet vacuum. So you can ask, what are the pros and cons of the top three selling pet vacuums? Now, I'm actually someone who does extensive research before I buy a product, and something like this would be immensely helpful where it actually lists pet vacuums with pros and cons, and of course, again, with those sources. So I can actually then dive deeper if I'd like to, and it condenses all of that research time to mere seconds. Okay, what about a cooking example? So let's talk about egg substitutes. And you can see here that it gives us a great list of egg substitutes for making a cake. And what's really cool in particular is that it kind of tells you, well, with these different substitutes, you can expect this type of cake. It's not locking you into one answer where it says the best egg substitute or this is how you substitute an egg, but it's giving you options with the potential results. Okay, now let's go to Bing Chat. So if I would have a search like the top selling 65-inch TVs, I would get something as I just showed you in the search examples before. If I come back up and I click this chat button, we get a whole new experience. We're now taken to a ChatGPT-like environment where everything else has been stripped away except that AI-given answer. And from here, we can kind of ask it anything just as you would with ChatGPT. I might just ask which of these is best for gaming. And you can see it says, you know, these have game modes and these have 120 hertz refresh rates. Both are super relevant for gaming. Now, let's say I also am on a budget. So I say, well, which one of these is the cheapest? And already it's sourcing prices from the internet on various websites and giving me a general feel for the price categories that these TVs fall into. This might be extremely useful for, again, kind of doing research without having to go site to site to site to site, because what Bing is doing is it's actually pulling its information from all of these different sites for you and just giving you back what you want. Now, a classic example that I also covered with ChatGPT was create an itinerary for, say, a 5-day trip to Mexico. Now, if you would do that in a normal search engine like Google, it would come up with something like this with a bunch of different websites and blogs of people who did 5-day trips, 7-day trips, the top 10 things, and so on. And you would have to read all of these and really kind of condense your information. If we go to Bing Chat, we can enter the same prompt just as you could with ChatGPT, and immediately you get some great information that it is a detailed 5-day itinerary telling you where you're arriving, where you should stay, what you should see, where you should get food, what kind of music you should listen to, and so on. It's such a great place to start your research. Now, that's not all it can do. You can follow up with something like create a summary of this itinerary that I can email to my family, and it essentially writes that email for you with, of course, the fill in the blank of your name. Now, let's say I also wanted to translate this. Of course, Bing can do that, and it can actually translate in 100 different languages. Now, you can also use Bing Chat as if it was a search engine itself. So I could search for something like top Japanese poets, and I get this interesting return that is according to Wikipedia. What's kind of cool is that it's personalized with a special touch. So it chose one of the poets, and then it says this is one of the most famous haikus by this poet, and then it even translates it into English since I wrote my prompt in English. I can then follow up and say, tell me more information about this poet, and I get kind of a detailed bio with, again, lots of sources, which is great. Bing has a few more tricks up its sleeve. So I could say something like, give me a meal plan for next week for my family of four that has vegetarian options and also caters to those who don't like nuts. And what's really cool is that it gives me kind of options for breakfast for each day. And what's really cool is you can follow up with that and say something like, give me a grocery list by grocery section of these ingredients. And it basically then makes a grocery list for me that I can easily go section by section and pick out what I need. But it doesn't have to all be serious. You can also say make games with Bing. So make a trivia quiz about 90s music. And here we get the questions as well as the answers. And that's pretty cool as well. But Bing isn't the only thing that Microsoft has kind of optimized. You might remember Edge, but this is a new Edge, much more sleek and modern. And yes, it's equipped with Bing AI. Let's check out what this can do. Imagine you're on a website like Gap and you want to look at the investors' relations, such as the Q3 earnings. Well, you can actually open that and then click on Bing AI. It pops out a little tab here with chat. You can actually say something so simple like, give me the key takeaways from this page. So you don't even need to copy and paste something. And what's great is that you can then continue the conversation here. For example, compare this with Lululemon in a table, and you get back exactly that, which is absolutely an incredible research tool built right into your browser. Of course, you can also use this for coding examples. Let's say you're on Stack Overflow and you want to convert this code from Python into Rust. Well, you just write that and you get back the code in Rust. Very, very useful for programmers. So there's a little look at being with the Prometheus model. And OpenAI is going to be constantly kind of going back and forth and testing this model and also analyzing the chats that are coming out of it. But what's really cool is that this will then go to improve this model. So you can see that Bing will constantly iterate to become a better and better search engine. And I think that is something that's really going to give it the edge over Google. So unless Google really has something special up its sleeve with Bard AI, I think this collaboration between Microsoft and OpenAI is really going to bring Bing and Edge to the next level and help Microsoft gain back some of that very valuable search real estate. I hope you enjoyed that first look at the new Bing, and if it was helpful for you, please think about subscribing and liking this video, as that helps me a lot in this endeavor of making these videos. See you guys next time.